2 weeks. When can we study? Yes,
ma'am.
Renaissance art. Very good. If we were studying Renaissance art, that was what topic we were studying, right? When we did, for example, Gandhi and Shivaji, what was that? What were we doing with Gandhi and Shivaji? Saksha?
Compare and contrast.
Right. I'm going to ask you, what is the rule of compare and contrast? According to what you know, what's the meaning of compare and contrast? I should see everyone's hand up because it's a very easy question. Now, we studied a lot about Renaissance art. And what I'm going to do first today is I'm going to do a recap of your Renaissance art. I hope you remember it because I asked you to read it, okay? So, we're going to start off with a recap about Renaissance art, okay? Then what Didi is going to do is that I have these sheets here, these fresh sheets of something called Impressionist art. Can you say the word Impressionist?
Impressionist.
Impressionism.
Impressionism.
Okay, so I have this, and at the back, this is called a compare and contrast map. Okay, it's a table. Very good. Thank you, Saksha. You correct me. It's not a map, it's a table. The map is the one that we do, right? And this one is the table. Okay, so we are going to do a recap, and then Didi is going to give these papers to you. We'll read it together, and when we are reading it, we're going to fill in the table at the
back.
Is that fine?
Yes.
When and where did Renaissance art start? When did it first begin? When did it first begin? Where did you?
Italy.
In Italy. Okay, do you want me to write that down?
Yes.
In Italy. And when? When was it? Swear.
14.
In the
1400s.
What is the meaning of Renaissance art? What was it? I'm saying Renaissance art. What was the meaning of Renaissance art?
In the middle, how in the classic ages they used to do like that only in middle ages there was lots of fighting and they are only drawing about their religion. So in the Renaissance age they told that only God is not important, we are also important. And then they draw themselves and they...
And what was that called? Humanism. Can you say humanism?
Humanism.
When they have, what was their style like? Was it, did they have a lot of details? Did it look real? Give me more about their style, Priya.
In Renaissance, he used to do lots of detailing and he used to use paintbrushes.
Very good. The paintbrushes he used to use were very fine so that we could add more
detail.
And how we add detail in our writing. Okay, what else? I want someone from here. Teva, can you tell me something?
With Renaissance art, they used to mix the colors on a palette and then paint it on their canvas. Okay, that's it. Enough. We had a recap and what's the time? Look at the time.
9 o'clock.
Okay, now, when I give you these sheets of paper, what you're going to do is you're only going to write your name and then you're going to turn it. So you write your name and then you'll
turn it.
And I'm only going to give you a very little amount of time. So take all the...
10 minutes.
10 minutes. No. Look at that part where you have turned it over. There are three words on the top. I'm going to ask Sachin, can you read those three words for me?
This is Impressionism, Renaissance art.
Okay, basis, Impressionism, Renaissance art. You know what Renaissance art is?
Yes.
I just told you that Impressionism is another art. What is that called?
Art
movement. Okay. And basis. I'm going to explain the word basis to you. Let me explain it. Wait. If I get Fahim and then I get Imran Khan, I want to say that Fahim is short and Imran is tall. What am I talking about? I'm talking about snow. I'm talking about their
height.
I'm talking about their height. Height is my basis. Fahim is short, Imran is tall. What am I comparing? Their
height.
Or if I'm saying Fahim is light and Imran is heavy, what am I comparing?
Weight.
And that is my basis. So what are you saying? You're saying they're different, but what are they different? How are they different?
Okay?
Now,
when I am going to be filling in this today, I'm going to be following a few steps. Okay? What I'm going to do is, Mushtaqa is on me, I'm going to read a paragraph. When I read the paragraph, I'm going to think, what is this paragraph telling me? I'm going to...
Let's write it.
No.
I'm going to self-monitor.
I'm going to self-monitor. I'm going to say, what is this telling me? And after that, I'm going to say, is this same for Renaissance and Impressionism or is it different? I'm giving you the steps again. Why did I hear? I'm going to read one paragraph and I'm going to think in my head, what is this telling me? Then I'm going to say, is this the same for Renaissance and Impressionism or is it different? Fair enough?
Okay.
A long time ago in Europe, a small group of artists began to produce paintings that were beautiful to look at. There is a word that we're not so familiar. Do not tell me the word. I want you to underline that word and on your own make an annotation. What do you think that word could mean? Underline the word produced. Don't tell me. And write down the meaning. Right. Okay, I know you. I can see Tayyabad's done. What could be the meaning of produce? Alright, pencils down. 5, 4, 3, Wahid 2, Wahid 1, and the last number, Priya and Marina, is 0. What do you think is the meaning of produce? They're saying that artists began to produce paintings. I'm going to ask someone who's not got a chance. Tanzira, how many people wrote make? Make. Very good. Very good. Simple enough.
Create.
Who wrote something different? Marina? You wrote create. Create. Make. What? I began to suck. It does not matter, hands down. It does not matter if you get the meaning wrong, as long as it makes sense in your head. Okay? When you're reading, sometimes you're gonna get the meaning wrong, and that is okay as long as the sentence is making sense in your head. So I'm gonna say, a long time ago in Europe, a small group of artists began to produce paintings, began to make paintings, began to create paintings that were beautiful to look at, but were different from art of the time. Exactly 1 minute. Okay, you read that paragraph quietly on your own, and when you feel you know what the paragraph is telling you, what should be the basis, then I want you to raise your hand. Okay, read the paragraph, the one that we just read. Tell me, what is it telling you about? Fahim, what is this paragraph telling you about mostly?
We get where and who made it.
Who made it? Who, where? And I'm going to ask someone else. Who, where, and how?
Which?
Okay, it's telling you where, it's telling you who, and it's telling you what?
When?
Okay? That was really good, guys. I'm a little bit impressed. Just a little, okay? So what is your basis? Your basis
when
is who,
where, and
where,
and who.
Where? Now, when did Impressionism start according to this? When did it start according to this? I'm seeing the same hands up, guys. I'm not happy about that. Junaid? In the 1860s. In which place? Someone else. In which place? Saja, come on, you can do this. In which place did it start? Give her a chance, guys. Which place did it start in? In? Alright. I want you, I'm going to ask Imran. Imran, can you read the first sentence for Sajia nice and loud and all hands up?
Although Impressionism later became an international art movement,
it originated in Paris. Now I'm going to ask Sajia, where was it started?
Very good.
Thank you. Good job. Yes. Okay. It originated in Paris. Okay, in the 1860s in Paris. Now I'm going to ask you, think back to the Renaissance, it's already on the board. Where did it originate and when? Firdosh? In the 1400s and where? Meher? In Italy. Is it the same or is it different? Both of them, yeah, it's a similarity that both of them are from Europe, yes. Okay.
But the country is different.
Okay, thank you, Sasha. Now, run you through the steps and you're going to do this independent. Are you going to talk to your partner? No. First, think about what is, it's usually the first sentence, we know that. What is this paragraph telling me most about? And then fill in your two and coming around to what? You can start now. You have exactly 5 minutes. Look at the first sentence to help you find your basics. What is it? Stop. Yeah, I think.
What are talking about? I'm asking most of
the questions. What is this paragraph mostly about?
Subject
matter.
Yes.
And it was right in the first. How many of you got that subject matter?
Really?
Okay. Really? Subject.
Okay, subject, yeah. Subject matter, yeah. Or what did they pay? 3, 2, and 1. Okay? It's 9:36, so I'm going to wrap up this class. And after this class, I'm going to be back in here. Okay? Now, what we studied today is not only art. You didn't study just impressionist art. Sure, you studied art, but you learned how to compare and contrast non-fiction passages from stories, right? Or we've done Shivaji. Even Shivaji is non-fiction, but we studied it like a story. Today, what we did is we took two really difficult passages, Renaissance and Impressionist art. I promise you, Zara penciled that. It's really tough. I'm proud of you for doing it. Okay? You were able to now know that when you compare and contrast, Zara, you need something called a basis. Basis is what is the reason, why. Okay? And then you compare one with a one topic with another topic. Is that fine?
Yes. Yeah.
Alright. If I were to give you something like this to do tomorrow, completely on your own, would you be able to?
Yeah.